Unlike other Codex compliant chapters, the Dark Angels use a system of coloured markings on the left knee pads of their warriors to designate which company the Marine is part of. And in this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint those company markings onto your miniatures. Now, in the Dark Angels, the first company is the Death Wing, the second company, the Raven Wing, and the 10th company are the Scouts. None of those use company markings as such, but for the 3rd through to the 9th, that's the Battle Companies and the Reserve Companies, they certainly do, and that's what we're going to show you in this video. Now, to demonstrate, we've got some Intercessors, a Hellblaster and an Assault Intercessor here, which we've undercoated with Chaos Black. We've painted the left leg here up to parade-ready standard as if it was a Dark Angel. Of course, you'll have painted the entire miniature at this point. We've just done this quickly to show you how it works. Now, the first one we're going to look at is the 3rd Company, that's the first Battle Company, who wear a red stripe on a green background. And for this, we'll start with a green background. We're simply going to paint Caliban green all over the knee pad. Now, for everything in this video, we're doing quite small detail, so grab your small airbrush. Let's take some Caliban green from the pot and onto our palette here. A little bit of water just to help thin it down. And then onto our Marine. Very simply, we're just going to paint the knee pad in now with Caliban green like so. You'll probably have done this at the same time you've done the rest of the Marine, but just in case you haven't, do it now. There we go, that's the Caliban green painted in. Okay, up next, let's draw the red stripe in using Mephiston Red. We'll then tidy up using Caliban Green again before highlighting the green areas with Warpstone Glow and the red stripe with Troll Slayer Orange. First of all, let's draw that stripe on with Mephiston Red. Again, grab your small airbrush. Let's take some paint from the pot here and onto our palette. Now, what I'm going to do here is add quite a bit of water to help thin it down, which will help drawing the freehand design on like this a little bit easier. There we go. I'm also going to make sure I keep a nice point on my small airbrush here as well. Perfect. Then, onto our Marine. Now, for the 3rd Company, the marking is a line that goes from the bottom left to the top right. So what I'm going to do here is simply draw a line that goes up like this across. Now, it's quite messy to start with. It's not a problem. Like this, over like so, to the top right. Perfect. Then, I'm just going to thicken that line up a little bit either side, just to make it a little bit bigger, like so. Just drawing very carefully up across like this over the Marine. Once we've drawn that line in, we're now going back in with Caliban Green to tidy it up. See, we made a bit of a mistake here at the top, so we're just going to tidy that back up again and cut in with this Caliban Green to make sure that line is nice and straight. With that now painted in, we're going to go back and highlight the green areas with Warpstone Glow. Then lastly, we've just got some Troll Slayer Orange here, and we're very carefully going to highlight the edges of the knee pad where the red areas are, like so. There we go, that's our 3rd Company marking complete. Okay, up next, let's have a look at painting the 4th Company, again another Battle Company, and their markings are a little bit more complex. We'll start off by painting a field of bone on the knee pad using Morgast Bone. Then we'll paint white on top of the knee pad using Korax White before tidying up the bone areas again with Morgast Bone. Again, we're using our small airbrush for this. Let's start off with Morgast Bone here. I'm going to take a little bit of paint from the pot and onto our palette. And again, we're going to thin it down with a touch of water here to help make sure it goes on really easily. Then onto our miniature. Here, we're simply going to paint the entire knee pad with Morgast Bone, like so. Now, if it's going on over a black undercoat, as we are here, you may find you need a couple of coats to get a nice solid colour. Simple enough, let the first coat dry, then apply a second thin coat over the top. But it's really important to get a nice solid colour on this particular paint. Up next, we've got Korax White, and here we're painting the top half of the knee pad with this colour. Just draw a sort of simple line across like so, across roughly the centre where the knee pad is, then fill in the top of the knee pad with Korax White. Next up, we've got Morgast Bone back out again, and here we're just going to tidy it up again. You can see there's a small mistake here. We're just going to tidy that back up again by painting over or cutting in with Morgast Bone. Again, just making sure that line is nice and straight. There we go, that's the white painted in, and we've also tidied up with the bone too. Okay, up next, let's start painting in those checks. Now for this, we're going to start off by painting a series of lines with a Baden Black to mark out where our checks are going to go. We'll then fill in the check pattern before tidying it up with Korax White to make sure all those checks are nice and equal. Then we'll grab our Morgast Bone one last time to tidy everything up, and finally highlight the bone areas with a Shafty Bone. So let's paint in those lines with a Baden Black. And for this, we've got our small layer brush. Let's take some paint from the pot. Now we're just looking for a tiny amount here on the end of the brush like this. Like that, there we go, not very much at all. Just a little bit of water here to help thin this down to make those lines go on real smooth. We're also making sure we've got a really nice fine point on the brush. That's perfect. Then, onto the Marine. Now this is quite steady work here, so make sure you're bracing your hand. And then we're going to draw some lines, and we're going to start off by drawing a single line that runs across the centre of the white section, like so. It's one line across like this, all the way along. Then we'll draw some vertical lines as well, going down. So we'll start about here and just draw one down like that, just down to where the white area stops. Then equidistant along, we're going to draw other black lines down like so. There we go. Doesn't matter if it reaches the bottom at the moment, just going to draw those lines in nice and neat across. Now what we're going to do once we've done these lines is we're going to go back now and fill in the check areas we want to be black. So for example, here I'll paint this section here black, like so. And then I'll paint this one up here black too. It's not too neat at the moment, that's not a problem. Just make sure you get a nice solid black colour as you're filling these in. I'm going to go back in a minute with other paints to help tidy these checks up. Once we've done that, we're now going back in with a Corax white here to tidy up the checks. What we're doing here is we're just cutting back into the black to make sure they're nice and equal sized and also nice and square. Just be really careful here and just make sure you're being as neat as you can with your checks. Next up, Morgast bone again. And here we're just tidying up again the bottom half of the knee pad, making sure we've got a nice straight line here, especially where it meets the checks. With that done, we're then going to highlight the bone areas of the knee pad here with a Shabti bone. There we go, that's our fourth company knee pad painted on. Okay, up next let's have a look at painting the fifth company. Here they wear a bone background with a green quarter and a black quarter painted in. We'll start off by painting the bone background with Morgast bone. Then we'll paint in the green quarter with Caliban green and the black quarter with the Baden black. Again, grab your small airbrush. Let's take some Morgast bone from the pot and onto our palette. Again, we're going to add a little bit of water here just to help thin it down to make sure it goes on real smooth onto our knee pad. There we go, a little bit more water in fact. There we go, it's perfect. Then onto the knee pad. Here we're painting it onto the knee pad here, cover the entire knee pad with this bone. You'll find probably as it goes on, you'll need a second coat. Again, not a problem. Let that first one dry and we'll apply a second coat over the top. Next up, I've got some Caliban green. Here I'm painting on the top right-hand side of my knee pad. So just drawing a small line down the center like so, until I get halfway down like that. Then I'm gonna draw across to the right-hand side of the knee pad like this. Then once I've done that, I'm gonna fill in this section. With that done, we're now doing the same on the bottom left-hand quarter, this time with a Baden black. Just gonna draw a quick line down like so to the bottom. There we go. And do the same again across this side of the knee pad as well. And then we're going to fill this area in with a Baden black once we've done that. There we go, that's the quarter painted in. Okay, up next, let's tidy that knee pad up using Morgast bone to make sure those lines are nice and straight. Then we'll take a Shabti bone and highlight the bone areas. Warpstone glow to highlight the green, and finally Dawnstone to highlight the black. First of all, Morgast bone. Again, grab your small airbrush. Let's take some paint from the pot here, and here I'm going to be using a little bit of water to help thin it down. Make sure it goes on real smooth. There we go. Nice point in the brush too. And onto the miniature here, we're just applying this onto the bone areas to make sure we get those lines nice and straight. We're just cutting in here just to make sure. You see that little ridge that comes out there? I'm just going to just paint that back in to make that line nice and straight. Then I've got a Shabti bone. I'm using this now to highlight the bone areas just around the edges of the knee pad, like this. Then we've got Warpstone Glow to highlight the top right section, the green section of our knee pad. Then we've got Dawnstone to highlight the bottom left section, the black section of the knee pad. There we go, that's our fifth company knee pad complete. Up next, let's have a look at painting the sixth company. That's the first reserve battle company. Now for this, we'll start off with a base of Morgast bone all over the knee pad. And then we'll paint half of the knee pad with Caliban green. Once we've done that, we'll go back to our Morgast bone again and tidy up the bone areas before highlighting the bone with a Shabti bone and the green with Warpstone glow. First of all, it's that Morgast bone. Again, grab your small airbrush. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. As always with the base paint, we're going to thin it down a touch to help it go on real smooth. Just like that. There we go. Then onto our model. Here, we're painting the entire knee pad here with Morgar's Bone. Now, as it goes on, especially over a black undercoat, you might find you need a second coat to get a nice solid colour. Just let the first one dry, and then we'll paint a second coat over the top. With that base coat applied, we've now got Caliban Green, and here we're painting in the right-hand side of the knee pad. I'm going to draw a sort of thin line down the centre, like so, like that, all the way down. I'm just going to fill in the right-hand side. You'll probably find you need a second coat to get a nice solid colour here. Not a problem. Just let that first coat dry again and apply a second over the top. Next up, we've got Morgar's Bone out again, and here we're just going to use it now to get a nice straight line down the centre of our knee pad. See, we've gone over a little bit at the bottom there. So we're going to use this now to paint over, get a nice straight line cutting back in to that green. With that done, we've now got a shapty bone, and here we're going to be highlighting the edges of the bone sections of the knee pad. Just very carefully, just working your way around the edges like so, just like that. Then we've got Warpstone Glow here to highlight the green areas of the knee pad. There we go, that's our sixth company knee pad complete. All right, up next, let's have a look at painting the seventh company again, a reserve battle company. Here they wear a green chevron on a bone background. We'll start off by painting the bone background first of all with Morgast Bone. Grab your small airbrush for this one. Let's take some paint from the pot again onto our palette here. Again, I'm going to thin it down to make sure it goes on real smooth. Perfect. Then onto our miniature. Here, we're applying this all over the knee pad like this. Again, just making sure you're being nice and neat. Don't hit the green areas around, obviously. You may find, again, you need a couple of coats to get a nice solid colour. Get a nice solid base coat of Morgast Bone there. There we go, that's the bone base coat applied. Right, up next, let's draw that chevron onto our knee pad. And to do this, we're actually going to use a bit of geometry. We're going to draw a cross, first of all, onto our knee pad using Caliban Green. We'll then join up some of the lines formed by the cross to make the chevron and then fill those lines in. For this, grab your small airbrush. Let's take some Caliban Green and apply it to our palette here. Now, for this, we want to be thinning it down quite a bit, as we're going to be drawing lines on this model, and we want to make sure those lines are nice and smooth, and also make sure we've got a nice fine point on the brush. Bang on, let's do this. So what we're going to do first here is just going to draw a cross onto our knee pad. Here we'll start at the top like so, and just draw a nice thin line down to the bottom like so. Straight as we can make it. There we go, up from the bottom like this. Then we'll form another part of the cross going across the knee pad from this side over. Don't worry about being too neat at the moment, it's not that important. There we go. Then, from the bottom, where the cross meets the bottom of the knee pad, here we'll draw a line from this section here to where it meets over here, like so, like that. Then, from the centre here, we'll draw another line parallel to that one we just drew, like this. Then we'll do the same again on this side. There we go, just going to draw that line on down there, like so. Again, don't worry about it being too neat at the moment, just going to draw a line on best we can, and again, from here, parallel to the centre. That forms a chevron now, which we're going to fill in like so, like this. There we go, that's the rough shape of the chevron drawn in. Okay, up next, let's have a look at tidying that up using Morgar's Bone. We'll use that to cut into the shape to neaten up those lines, and also to hide the lines we want hiding. Once we've done that, we'll then highlight the bone area with our shapty bone, followed by highlighting the green areas with Warpstone Glow. First of all, it's that Morgast Bone. Grab your small airbrush again. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Again, a cheeky little bit of water just to help thin it down. Maybe a bit more. There we go. Perfect. And onto our miniature. Here what we're doing is we're using the Morgast Bone to cut into and tidy up the knee pad. So for example, we're going to paint over this line here. We want to get rid of that now, don't we? And also we're going to be using it now to tidy up these lines here all over the chevron to make sure it's nice and straight and pointed. Now you might find you need a couple of coats to get a nice strong colour to make sure those lines are nice and neat. Not a problem, just take your time on this one. Just work around the knee pad like so, making sure those lines are nice and neat. With that done, we've got a shapty bone, and now we're highlighting the edge of the bone parts of the knee pad. Then the tiniest touch of Warpstone Glow is being used here, just where the green parts meet the edge of the knee pad. There we go, that's our seventh company knee pad complete. Up next, the 8th. This is the Reserve Assault or Close Support Company, and they wear a knee pad that is halved green and black. Now we'll start off by painting the green sections in with Caliban green. Then we'll tidy up the black sections with Abaddon black. Then we'll highlight the black sections with Dawnstone and the green sections with Warpstone glow. First of all, it's that Caliban green. Again, grab your small airbrush. Let's take some paint from the pot, as always, onto our palette here. Just a little bit of water to help thin it down. There we go, like so. Then onto our miniature. Now, for this particular knee pad, what we're going to be doing here is drawing a small line here from bottom left up to top right, like so. And then we're filling in that side of the knee pad. It's sort of like a diagonal half motif here. So that's what we're looking for here. And then this bottom right-hand section is painted in with Caliban green. Next up, we're filling in the top left-hand section and neatening up that line again with Abaddon black. With that done, we're now highlighting the black sections of the knee pad here with Dawnstone. It's a very, very light, fine highlight around the edge of the knee pad. Then we're highlighting the green areas of the knee pad with Warpstone glow. Again, just working around the edge of the knee pad like this. There we go, that's the 8th company knee pad done. Last but not least, let's have a look at painting the 9th company markings here. This is the Reserve Devastator or Fire Support Company. They wear a red stripe on a bone background as their company markings. So for this, we'll start off with the bone background. We'll paint that with Morgas bone on our knee pad. Once we've got a nice solid base coat of Morgas bone, we'll then draw on the stripe with Mephiston red. We'll then go back with the Morgas bone and tidy up the bone areas before highlighting the bone with a Shabti bone and the red with Trollslayer orange. First of all, it's that Morgas bone base coat. Grab your small airbrush again for this. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. And again, a little bit of water to help thin it down, make sure it goes on real smooth. There we go, that's great. Then onto our miniature. Here, I'm just going to be taking our Hellblaster's knee pad and just painting it with Morgas bone all over like so to get a nice solid colour. You may find you need a second coat to get a nice solid colour. Not a problem, let the first one dry once again, then paint a second coat over the top. Once we have a nice solid base coat, now we're drawing a horizontal red line across the knee pad, like so, just taking it across like this. There we go. Now it'll be quite rough when you first draw it on, that's not a problem. We're going to go back and thicken it up a little bit to make it look more like a bar. Now we're going to go back with the Morgas bone, just tidy up those lines to make sure they're not so wavy and a little bit straighter. Just going to cut back in, just tidying up those lines now to make them a bit thinner and neater. Next up, we've got a Shabti bone, and here we're going to be adding a highlight to the edge of the knee pad in the bone areas, just working our way around, stopping when we get to the red areas. Then we've got some Trollslayer orange, and we're using that to highlight where the red areas meet the edge of the knee pad, just very, very subtly. There we go, that's our 9th company knee pad complete. All right, but I'm going to show you one last thing here, just a quick optional extra you can paint onto your knee pads to make them look a bit more weathered and beaten. This will work on whichever company marking you've got on your knee pad, but we're going to show you how it works on this 9th company one. Here I'm going to take the original base colour, which is Morgas bone, and use it to chip into the red stripe. Grab yourself a small airbrush for this. Let's take some Morgas bone from the pot and onto the palette here. A little bit of water to help thin it down, not too much though. Perfect, nice point on the brush, then onto the miniature. Here, I'm just going to add tiny flicks and checks going in from the bone area just into the red. So you can see just a little bit like that, for example, there. A little, maybe a little bit going in there, just making that line not look quite as straight as it was. Maybe just a little check in there as well, a little chip there as well. Do just as much as little as you like to make that knee pad look a bit more beaten up and weathered. There we go, that's the chipping complete on that knee pad. You can see it makes a real big difference. Give it a try on whichever company marking you've got. And there we go, that's how you can paint company markings onto your Dark Angels Space Marines. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting.